So as a student, when I go ahead and click on the link, whether it was shared to me through Google Classroom, Reminder, wherever, you'll notice that this is now, again, set up for private, and it's set up to just allow those Georgetown County School District students. And we set that up in the teacher column. So I'm just going to go ahead and, as a student, click Join with Google. You'll notice it's going to ask me for my Google account. I click on it. And then again, I can see the prompt right here. Again, the video feature that we put in, if I click here, it'll go ahead and take us to that video. It's also added down here. I can see this side, and I've got the image over on this side. So when I'm ready as a student to go ahead and record my response, I'll go ahead and I'll click on record. And I just want to show you a couple of the cool features inside of this. So again, under options, before I start recording, it shows me I can upload a video. So if I went ahead and use like Screencastify or Loom, and I wanted to go ahead and put that presentation here, this is where I would do that. I can mirror video, I can mute my mic, or I can also record my screen. Is again a great feature in this that they've just updated. So the other side to this are the effects. So students also have the choice to where they can go ahead and they can change the filters in this. For instance, if they want to go ahead and put in bricks, you can see now like how cool this is. So again, I could go ahead and it's kind of like the mask, you know, it gives me some a little bit of a disguise in here when I'm recording. I could go with pixels. Again, I could add in a little rainbow effect, or I could just take off the filters. There we go. And you come back. So the other thing is with frames, this is pretty cool too. So you can see, I can decide if I want to add a little personal flair to this. A lot of the students love the breaking news one to kind of act as a newscaster. You can see we've got some retro ones. And again, it just allows the students, again, just some personalization on this. I'm going to clear the frame for this. And then you also see the emoji. This is pretty cool because if I click on the emoji one, maybe I need to go ahead and I don't want everybody to see my face necessarily, but I do want them to see the background. So I could go ahead and I could put this emoji here like a mask and record with the emoji here. It's a pretty cool feature and a way to put that in. I'm going to remove this. We'll come back down to it. I can also add text as a student. I just click on this, and then again, I just start typing. So if I needed, you know, some sort of title or some sort of text to stay there, this is a way to go ahead and do that. If I want to remove it, again, you'll see when I come down here, make this disappear, and I click on it, I can just go ahead and hit delete. Another effect besides text, and we'll go back out of text styles, is I can also use the draw tool. I can also, and again, it'll allow me to go ahead and pick a pen and draw while I'm presenting. I can also use a board tool. This is pretty cool. So if I push this, I'm going to have a board over here that I can use. If I don't want the board, I just hit clear board. And then again, I'm going to move that away. And then finally, if I want to add some sort of photo, I can do that right here. So again, some pretty cool effects in this, and students can use it however they want. So apparently the breaking news is that there's a fire alarm going off here, or some sort of alarm. Either way, I just want to show you that in this, once I'm ready and I've picked my features as a student, I just click this record. It gives me a countdown. I then will answer the prompt and go ahead and speak through the prompt. And then when I'm done, you'll notice as I'm talking, it's telling me I only have a minute and 20 seconds left. So as I'm done recording, I hit the pause button. Then I hit the next. When I'm done, it's going to preview. I can click the edit button and I can trim this. Again, it allows me to do some of those features. For this, I'm just going to leave it. Again, it's going to give me a display name. I could add a link if I wanted to. It will also allow me to select the frame, take a selfie.
You heard that little alarm sound? Please disregard. Please disregard. Thank you.
All right, so you can see that there is no emergency here, thanks to Mr. Del Bagno. He has let us know that that alarm is nothing that we need to worry about. So again, I could add a name tag if I wanted to. I can add a link, I could add a title, and then finally I hit submit. And as a student, boom, it tells me I'm successful. How cool is that? And then again, when I complete this, you'll now see my video is right here for my peers to go ahead and review. All they have to do is click on it. And again, you can see the way that we had this set up. They could add a text response, or they could even go ahead and hit a video response. And then they could do the same thing and say, thank goodness during your video that that alarm was nothing for us to worry about. We're so glad. They hit the pause button. They hit the next. Same sort of things as before. And then they confirm. And so now students can reply to students via video if you set it up that way. Again, if you're worried about these types of things, all you have to do is moderate posts and comments. And that was back on the teacher side that we showed you how to do that. So again, you'll see that it shows me that not only did someone view it, but they also replied to my video. So again, this is a really cool feature. It's fun for students, it's interactive. So I encourage you to go ahead and publish your students' thinking to an authentic audience. Good luck.